In this video, we'll be working with negative exponents. You may recall that 5x to the negative 3 is written the same, or means the same, as 5 over x to the positive 3, and the x to the positive 3, or x cubed, is in the denominator. If there is a plus or minus sign, we can't just move terms. Instead, make little fractions. What this means is, if you look at a complex fraction, or compound fraction, and you see that there's plus or minus signs in between each of the terms in the numerator and denominator, then you need to just rewrite it with little fractions in their place, because the signs in the exponents, notice, are negative. In the denominator, I have 1 minus 25x to the second, negative 2. So, I'll put 25 in the numerator, and x to the second in my denominator. From here, I need to figure out what my LCD will be. Notice that the highest exponent in my denominator is x to the second. So I'm going to multiply everything in my numerator by x to the second, and everything in my denominator by x to the second. See? It's like multiplying by a funny looking one. When I distribute that x squared, the denominators in my fraction, both in the numerator and the denominator, will divide out. When I multiply x squared to 1, I just get x squared. Multiplying x squared to 10 over x allows me to divide out 1x, and I'm left with 10x in the numerator. And multiplying x squared to 25x squared over x squared allows me to divide out the complete x squared, and all I'm left with is the 25. In the denominator, I have an x squared multiplied to 1, which gives me x squared, and I'm multiplying x squared to negative 25 over x squared as well, which allows me to divide out the x squareds, and I'm left with just negative 25. From here, I can factor my numerator and factor my denominator and see if anything divides out. The numerator factors to x plus 5 times x plus 5, and in the denominator, it factors to x plus 5 times x minus 5. An x plus 5 is common to both the numerator and the denominator. They divide out, and I'm left with x plus 5 divided by x minus 5. In example 2, I have negative exponents, and so I'll rewrite them as little fractions. 8 over b to the third plus 27 over a to the third. In the denominator, I have 4 over a b to the third minus 6 over a to the second, b to the second, plus 9 over a to the third, b. If I look at my exponents, I see that the common or highest exponent for my LCD will have to be a to the third, b to the third. When I multiply that through, to all the terms in the numerator and the denominator, I can clear out my denominators. I'll get 8 a to the third plus 27 b to the third. In the denominator, I'll have 4 a to the second minus 6 a b plus 9 b squared. Notice that I divide out the common factors between a to the third, b to the third, and any common factors in each denominator, in each of my terms. From here, I need to see if my numerator or my denominator will factor. My numerator does factor. It factors 2a plus 3b because it's a sum of cubes, and I'm left with 4a squared minus 6ab plus 9b squared. And in the denominator, nothing factors. It's exactly what it was before. But notice that the numerator factor matches the denominator exactly, so they divide out. And my final answer is 2a plus 3b